Emotional eating is incredibly common. I have touched on this topic throughout the lessons. It is often called stress eating, compulsive eating, or binge eating. For all intents and purposes, I will lump all of these together here. In the next slide, I'll explain a little more about binge eating disorder. Let me start with what emotional eating is not. It is not a sugar craving or addiction to sugar or food. It is not a character flaw, and it is not a lack of discipline or willpower. Ultimately, emotional eating undermines success in managing weight, impairs health, and diminishes the quality of your life. I will touch on emotional eating here, but there is a full lesson on emotional eating, compulsive eating, stress eating, and binge eating coming up shortly. The term binge may mean different things to different people. The commonality is that binge always means eating an unusually large amount of food. But the severity of the binge or the amount varies for different people. In clinical practice, when the process gets serious enough, it's known as binge eating disorder. Now, the biggest difference between emotional, compulsive eating, stress eating, and an actual clinical definition of binge eating disorder is that binge eating disorder is characterized by a feeling of loss of control, of being out of control. Whether or not you struggle at a subclinical or clinical level, the treatment is the same, and we will go over this process here. If you do think that you are suffering with binge eating disorder, it is worth talking to your doctor and seeing other health professionals. Depression and anxiety disorders often accompany binge eating disorder, so seeking a mental health professional is also advised.